are going to discuss about the preparation methods of halogen derivatives. So first of all, preparation methods of alkyl halides and then the preparation methods of aryl halide. So there are three preparation methods for alkyl halides. First one is from alcohols. Alcohols can be converted into alkyl halides by replacing the OH group from alcohol by corresponding halogen. And there are three different ways for converting alcohols to alkyl halide. So first is by using any haloacid. Haloacid is the acid in which any one of the halogen is present, like HCl, HBr or HI. So alcohol can be converted into alkyl halide by using any one of the haloacid, by first method. Then second method is by using phosphorus halides, phosphorus trihalide or phosphorus pentahalide. So alcohol can also be converted into alkyl halide by using phosphorus halides. That is the second method from alcohol. And in third method, alcohol can be converted into alkyl halide by using thionyl chloride, which is SOCl2. This is supposed to be the best method for the preparation of alkyl halides from alcohols. The reason behind that is the byproducts formed in these reactions are gases and therefore they can be easily separated. This is the best method for the preparation of alkyl halide. These are the three methods by which alcohols can be converted into corresponding alkyl halide. Method for the preparation of alkyl halide, that is from hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons like alkanes and alkenes. So alkane can be converted into alkyl halide, but the problem is when alkane is halogenated, it gives monohalo, dihalo, trihalo as well as tetrahalo derivative. So it is very difficult to separate monohalogen derivative from the mixture. So this method, which is from alkane to alkyl halide, is somewhat difficult for the preparation of alkyl halide. So this is not the proper method. But alkenes can be easily converted into alkyl halide by simple hydrohalogenation. Whenever alkenes undergo hydrohalogenation in presence of any haloacid, they are converted into the corresponding alkyl halide. So second method is the proper method for the preparation of alkyl halide from hydrocarbon, which is alkene. Then third method for the preparation of alkyl halide is by halogen exchange. In this method, one alkyl halide can be converted into another alkyl halide by replacing the halogen. So, by this method, we can prepare alkyl iodides or alkyl fluorides from alkyl chloride or alkyl bromide. So, there are two different methods which are also called as named reactions. And these methods are Finkelstein reaction and Schwartz reaction. So, by halogen exchange, we can prepare iodides and fluorides. So this is the method in which one alkyl halide can be converted into another alkyl halide. These are three preparation methods for alkyl halides only. Secondly, aryl halide, preparation methods of aryl halides. So aryl halides can be prepared by two different methods. First method is the electrophilic substitution. And second method is the name reaction, which is Sandmeier's reaction. So these are the only two methods for the preparation of aryl halide. In the first reaction, there is electrophilic substitution of benzene. So directly benzene can be converted into aryl halide, or any other compound of benzene can be substituted electrophilically and gives the corresponding alkyl halide. In the second method, which is Sandmeier reaction, this is also one of the named reactions. So this method can also be used for the preparation of corresponding alkyl halide. So these are the two methods. The preparation methods of alkyl halides. Alkyl halides are first prepared from alcohols. Alcohols have general formula ROH. And if you want to convert alcohol into alkyl halide, which is RX, you have to replace OH group by halogen, corresponding halogen. So we have to use the reagent which will give that halogen. So first method from alcohol uses haloacid. Haloacids are HCl, HBr or HI. So any one of these haloacid can be used to convert this alcohol to alkyl halide. That means this OH group can be substituted by halogen which gives the haloacid. So we can start with the HCl. Now alcohols like alkyl halides are of three types: primary alcohol, secondary alcohol and tertiary alcohol. If this R group is primary group, then the alcohol is called primary alcohol, and secondary if R group is secondary, then it is called secondary alcohol. We can use any alcohol to convert it into the corresponding alkyl halide, but primary and secondary alcohols are very less reactive, so we have to use some reagent or catalyst. But tertiary alcohol can directly convert it into the corresponding alkyl halide. So we will start with any alcohol. Oscar, this is the first example of alcohol. This is ethyl alcohol. Now we have to convert ethyl alcohol to the corresponding alkyl halide. If you convert ethyl alcohol in the alkyl halide, just replace OH group by halogen. We are taking here chlorine. So in this particular reaction, OH group from alcohol is replaced by chlorine. And if you want to use the reagent out of these three haloacids, you can select HCl as the reagent. So when you start with the reactant and with the product, you have to write the reagent here. So we are using HCl for converting or for replacing OH group by chlorine. But the alcohol we have used, which is ethyl alcohol, is primary alcohol because of OH group is present on primary carbon. So this alcohol is primary alcohol and reactivity of primary alcohol is very less. So HCl alone cannot convert alcohol to alkyl halide. So along with HCl we have to use zinc chloride, and togetherly HCl and zinc chloride, they are called Lucas reagent. Whenever primary alcohol is to be converted into the corresponding alkyl halide, HCl is to be treated with zinc chloride and then only the reaction is possible. Now this reaction is very simple. OH group can be replaced by chlorine, and when OH combines with hydrogen, byproduct will be water. So from ethyl alcohol you have got ethyl chloride. If we want to prepare the alkyl halide, which is tertiary butyl chloride. Now this alkyl halide is tertiary alkyl halide, and we have to start with the alcohol. That should be tertiary butyl alcohol. Now in this reaction, you have to just replace OH group by chlorine, and the reagent used will be HCl. But in this reaction, no need to use zinc chloride, because HCl can react with tertiary alcohol very easily, as the reactivity of tertiary alcohol is very high as compared to secondary or primary alcohol. So this can directly convert tertiary butyl alcohol to tertiary butyl chloride, and as usual byproduct will be water. So this is the reaction which gives alkyl halide from primary, secondary and tertiary alcohol using Lucas reagent. Okay, now we have to convert ethyl alcohol to ethyl bromide. So if you want to use any haloacid, you have to use HBr as the haloacid. Now HBr is not readily available, so we have to prepare it in situ, and for the in situ preparation, HBr is prepared by using NaBr with concentrated H2SO4. When they react togetherly, they form HBr. And then this HBr reacts with the corresponding alcohol and it replaces OH group by bromine, and byproduct usual is water. So this is how ethyl alcohol is converted into ethyl bromide. where OH group is replaced by bromine and the reagent uses HBr. So this is how you can convert secondary alcohol to secondary alkyl halide, tertiary alcohol to tertiary alkyl halide. This is a simple method. Now we have to convert ethyl alcohol to ethyl iodide. So halo acid used will be HI, and like HBr, HI is also prepared in situ by using sodium iodide and phosphoric acid, which is H3PO4. The mixture gives the hydrogen iodide, and HI replaces OH group by iodine. Byproduct will be water. This is how ethyl alcohol is converted into ethyl iodide, and these are the three halo acids which give corresponding alkyl halide from primary alcohol, secondary alcohol, as well as tertiary alcohol. Alcohols can be converted into alkyl halide by all these reagents, which are phosphorus halides. These are phosphorus trihalide, and this is phosphorus pentahalide. Phosphorus trichloride, phosphorus tribromide, phosphorus trihalide, phosphorus pentachloride. So first of all, we will start with phosphorus trihalides, PCl3, PBr3, PI3. So any alcohol you can take, we will take ethyl alcohol, and we have to convert it into ethyl chloride. So again, simply we have to replace OH by Cl, but the reagent used out of this should be PCl3. And when PCl3 reacts with corresponding alcohol, it replaces OH group by halogen. The byproduct form is phosphorus acid, H3PO3. Okay, so in this particular reaction, OH from alcohol is replaced by chlorine by using phosphorus trichloride. Now, if you want ethyl bromide from ethyl alcohol, so OH is to be replaced by bromine. So now you cannot use PCl3 as a reagent. You have to use PBr3. But this PBr3 is not directly available. It is to be again prepared with in situ. So phosphorus, red phosphorus, when treated with bromine, it forms PBr3. And when PBr3 is used as a reagent, OH is replaced by bromine. And again, byproduct will be phosphorus acid, H3PO3. So this is how alcohol can be converted into alkyl halide by using PCl3 or PBr3. You can also convert it by using phosphorus triiodide, which is prepared by red phosphorus and iodine. It converts alcohol to alkyl iodide. So if you want to replace OH group by chlorine, you have to use PCl3. If you want to replace OH by bromine, you have to use PBr3. And for iodine, you have to use PI3. So this is the method for converting alcohol to alkyl halide. It can be converted into ethyl chloride by using one more reagent, which is phosphorus pentachloride, PCl5, which is readily available. So this will convert OH group to chlorine, and byproduct here changes to HCl and phosphorus chloride, POCl3. So by using PCl3, PBr3, PI3 and PCl5, corresponding alcohol can be converted into alkyl halide, chloride, bromide or iodide. So that's all about the reaction with phosphorus halide. So third method for the preparation of alkyl halides from alcohols is by using thionyl chloride, which is SOCl2. So if you have to convert ethyl alcohol into ethyl chloride, you can use one more reagent, which is called thionyl chloride. It is SOCl2, which replaces OH from alcohol by chlorine, and the byproduct form is SO2 and HCl. Both the byproducts are in the gaseous form, so they can be easily separated, easily evaporated, and no need to separate the product from byproducts. So this one is the best method for the preparation of alkyl chlorides. Alkyl iodides or alkyl bromides are not prepared by this method. So this is the method which is used to convert alcohol into alkyl chloride only. And this reaction is carried out in presence of pyridine under reflux. So this one is the method to prepare alkyl chlorides. The second method for the preparation of alkyl halide is from hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons which are used to prepare alkyl halides are alkanes or alkenes. But in the first method where alkanes are used as a starting material, if you start with methane on halogenation, it will form methyl chloride. This is the desired product, but if the halogenation is carried out with alkane, it will not stop at monohalo state, and this monohalo derivative is further converted into dihalo derivative. Then it is further converted into trihalo, and finally you get tetrahalo derivative by the same chlorine which is added, because this is the continuous method and exhaustive method, so this cannot be controlled at this stage, and therefore this is not the proper method for the preparation of alkyl halide only, because it forms monohalo, dihalo, trihalo as well as tetrahalo product. So you have to separate it from their mixture, and which is very difficult. So this is not the proper method for the preparation of alkyl halides. So we can use alkenes instead of alkanes for the preparation of alkyl halide. Second method for the preparation of alkyl halide from hydrocarbon we are using is alkene. This one is the reaction which is studied in 11th standard. So you can take any alkene. I am taking ethene here. So ethene can be converted into ethyl chloride, ethyl bromide or ethyl iodide by the method which is called hydrohalogenation. Now we want the halogen chlorine, therefore we are taking the halo acid, which is HCl, hydrochloric acid, and this one is the reaction which is studied at 11th standard. What happens in this reaction? Hydrogen and halogen which are present in the halo acids are added across the double bonded carbons. In this way, this hydrogen goes to one carbon and chlorine goes to another carbon, and double bond is converted into single bond. So CH2 becomes CH3 and this CH2 becomes CH2Cl. So this is the simple addition method across the double bond. When we take, so here we are taking propene as the starting material and HCl is added to propene. Now what happens in this reaction? Hydrogen is to be added to one double bonded carbon and chlorine is to be added to the another double bonded carbon. Now first of all we will mark the double bonded carbon. This is the one double bonded carbon. This is another carbon. Now these two carbons are not equal or symmetrical, as in case of ethene. These two carbons were symmetrical, so you can send hydrogen to any carbon, chlorine to any carbon, but in this case, in case of propene, you cannot send hydrogen to any carbon or chlorine to any carbon. There you have to follow a rule which is called Markovnikov's rule. And according to this rule, when unsymmetrical reagent is added to an unsymmetrical alkene, then negative part of the reagent goes to that double bonded carbon which carries less number of hydrogens. That means now you have to send halogen to the carbon carrying less hydrogens, and out of these two double bonded carbons, this is the carbon carrying less hydrogens, so chlorine should get attached to the middle carbon and not this carbon, and then obviously hydrogen will go to this carbon. So now the product will be CH3 CHCl and CH3. So when you start with propene, you will get isopropyl chloride as the major product, and this one is the major product, and you'll get N-propyl chloride as the minor product, which is in very less amount. So this is what called Markovnikov's addition. According to this addition, whenever the unsymmetrical alkene is hydrohalogenated, it gives mixture of two products. One of them is major, and it is according to the Markovnikov's addition. Now, if you add HBr instead of HCl on the same alkene, which is propene, then in this case you will get isopropyl bromide. You can prepare bromide chloride iodide by using the corresponding acid. Okay, now if you add unsymmetrical reagent to the unsymmetrical alkene, and if the reaction is carried out in presence of peroxides like hydrogen peroxide, sodium peroxide or benzoyl peroxide, then what happens? The reaction gets reversed. That means in this case we are adding unsymmetrical reagent and alkene is also unsymmetrical, but according to Markovnikov's rule, bromine will not go to carbon carrying less number of hydrogen, it will go to carbon carrying more number of hydrogen, and now hydrogen will go to the carbon carrying less number of hydrogen. So product of this particular reaction, which is propene and HBr, whenever in presence of hydrogen peroxide, is not isopropyl bromide. In this case addition gets reversed, so it is called anti-Markovnikov's addition, and therefore the major product is not isopropyl, it will be N-propyl bromide. This is called anti-Markovnikov's addition, anti-Markovnikov's rule, or which is also called as Karasch effect or peroxide effect. But peroxide effect is observed only in case of HBr. If you use HCl or HI, and if the reaction is carried out in presence of peroxide, it doesn't matter, it will always give secondary alkyl halide or isopropyl halide. This is the method for the preparation of alkyl halides from alkene. In this method, across the double bonded carbons, hydrogen and halogen are added. If the alkene is unsymmetrical, you have to follow Markovnikov's rule. If the alkene is unsymmetrical and reaction is carried out in presence of peroxide, the peroxide effect is observed, but only in case of HBr. So we have to remember that always you have to find the double bonded carbons and mark them, and then only you have to add hydrogen and halogen. That's it. Third method for the preparation of alkyl halides is by halogen exchange. Now in this method we can prepare alkyl iodides or alkyl fluorides by any other alkyl halide. So first of all we'll prepare alkyl iodide. So we will start with alkyl chloride. I will take ethyl chloride, and this ethyl chloride, we have to convert it into ethyl iodide. So simple reaction is replacement of chlorine by iodine, and for that we can use sodium iodide in presence of dry acetone. Reaction is replacement of chlorine by iodine, and this chlorine is removed with sodium as NaCl, and this can be easily separated because it forms a precipitate. This is the method in which chloride or bromide can be converted into iodide, and this is one of the named reactions. It is called Finkelstein reaction. So second method for the preparation of alkyl fluoride from any alkyl halide. So we will again start with chloride, and to prepare fluoride. So here there is replacement of chlorine by fluorine. So reagent used here can be silver fluoride or mercuric fluoride or arsenic fluoride or antimony fluoride. So that chlorine or bromine from the alkyl halide can be replaced by fluorine. Byproduct form will be HCl, which is also easily precipitated. And this is the reaction in which alkyl fluorides are formed, is also one of the named reactions, and it is called Schwartz reaction. These two are the named reactions which are called halogen exchange reactions. By these reactions you can prepare iodides and fluorides only from chlorides or bromides. So that is all about the preparation methods of alkyl halides. There are three preparation methods. First one is from alcohols, second one is from alkanes and alkenes, and third one is by halogen exchange. The next point is the preparation of aryl halides. Aryl halides are also prepared by two methods. First is electrophilic substitution and second one is Sandmeyer reaction. So we will start with the first method, which is electrophilic substitution. So this one is the method which is studied in aromatic compound. So benzene can be directly converted into chlorobenzene, bromobenzene or iodobenzene by direct halogenation. So that is also studied in 11th standard. If benzene is treated with halogen in presence of anhydrous aluminium trichloride, hydrogen from benzene is replaced by halogen and the byproduct is HCl. So these are the replaceable hydrogens which are present on benzene, and any one of the hydrogen can be replaced by chlorine, bromine or iodine to give the corresponding halobenzene. This is an example of electrophilic substitution. So by this method you can directly prepare chlorobenzene, bromobenzene or iodobenzene. Instead of benzene, if we take any other compound of benzene, then you will get the corresponding ortho and para products. For example, if we start with toluene, which is the compound of benzene, and if you carry out chlorination of toluene, you will get orthochlorotoluene and parachlorotoluene. So like benzene, any other compound of benzene can also be converted into halobenzene by using halogenation as electrophilic substitution method. Second method for the preparation of aryl halides is Sandmeyer reaction, which is also one of the named reactions. And starting material used in Sandmeyer reaction is diazonium salt. This diazonium salt is prepared from primary amines on diazotization. So diazonium salt is drawn as benzene N2X. This nitrogen is bonded to benzene, carries positive charge, and hydrogen carries negative charge. At the place of hydrogen you can put chlorine, bromine or iodine, any halogen. When the diazonium salt is treated with a particular reagent, the whole group N2X is replaced by the corresponding halogen like chlorine, bromine or iodine. So if we want to prepare chlorobenzene from benzene diazonium salt, then the reagent which is used is copper chloride in presence of HCl. So this is the reaction called Sandmeyer reaction, and byproduct form in this reaction is always N2. If you want to prepare bromobenzene by this method, then the reagent used will be copper bromide in presence of HBr. This is the best method for the preparation of chloro and bromobenzene from diazonium salt, because the group is easy leaving group, so it leaves benzene ring very easily and undergoes nucleophilic substitution reaction. This is the nucleophile which is attached to the benzene after substitution, and both these reactions in which chlorobenzene and bromobenzene is formed from this is the conversion of diazonium salt into chlorobenzene or bromobenzene by using copper chloride and copper bromide. The same conversion can be carried out by using copper powder in presence of HCl or HBr. That will also give chlorobenzene or bromobenzene, but that reaction is called Gaterman reaction. And whenever this conversion is carried out in presence of copper chloride or copper bromide, it is called Sandmeyer reaction. So that is the difference, because reactant and products are same, but the reagent used is different for two different reactions. If this one is used, it is called Sandmeyer reaction. And if copper powder is used, it is called Gaterman reaction. Diazonium salt can also be converted into iodobenzene, but that will not come under Sandmeyer reactions, because it is not by using copper iodide. We are using potassium iodide here, and then diazonium group is converted into iodine, or it is replaced by iodine. Byproduct always formed is N2. So this is the different reagent, but you can prepare iodobenzene from benzene diazonium. This is how we have finished the preparation methods of alkyl and aryl halides. So to revise the preparation methods, this is the chart to be remembered. For the preparation of alkyl halides, there are three methods. First method is from alcohols. Alcohols can be converted to alkyl halide by using halo acids like HCl, HBr or HI. By using phosphorus halides like PCl3, PBr3, PI3 or PCl5. And also the reagent used, which is SOCl2 thionyl chloride, for the preparation of alkyl chlorides only. That is the reaction from alcohols. Secondly, they are prepared from hydrocarbons like alkanes and alkenes. Alkanes on halogenation give alkyl halides, but they give poor yield. And alkenes on hydrohalogenation give alkyl halide. Here you have to remember the Markovnikov's and anti-Markovnikov's addition. Third method for the preparation of alkyl halide is by halogen exchange. There are two named reactions. Finkelstein reaction is used for the preparation of alkyl iodides, and Schwartz reaction is used for the preparation of alkyl fluorides. These are the two methods for the preparation of aryl halides. First one is by electrophilic substitution. Benzene or benzene compounds can be directly substituted by corresponding halogen. So this is electrophilic substitution. And second method is named reaction Sandmeyer reaction. In this method, we are using benzene diazonium salt as a starting material, and that salt, when treated with copper chloride or copper bromide, they form corresponding chlorobenzene or bromobenzene as a product. So that is all about the preparation methods. There are five methods for alkyl and aryl halide together.